All right, next movement on hands and knees in our quadrupedal stance is our traditional cat-cows, and then we'll take a few variations. So, starting at our cat-cows, we're inhaling as we slowly lift our head and our tail towards the sky. As we exhale, we're rounding the spine, head and tail reaches towards the floor as we draw belly button in. Again, we'll inhale, lifting head and tail. Letting everything drop, exhaling as we round. So this movement is to warm up the spine. I'm just starting to become aware of both the front side body and the back side body. All right, adding on, we'll start to integrate our pelvic floor. The pelvic floor being a line, a sheet of muscles that is along our pelvic bone. And we can utilize cat-cow to start to activate that muscle. So as you inhale and reach your head and tail towards the sky, you can think about relaxing the pelvic floor, pushing those muscles downward. As we exhale, you can make a shh sound and draw the pelvic floor up like you're trying to suck up a blueberry in between our holes, pushing into the floor. Again, relaxing the pelvic floor as we lift, and then exhale as we push into the floor, lifting up with the pelvic floor. You can try that a few more times. Everybody could benefit from starting to draw more attention to our pelvic floor, and this is just a nice way to start to get in touch with that. Beautiful. All right, let's pause. Final, more advanced version of cat-cow is adding in a child's pose. So how we'll do that, we'll inhale, head and tail lifts, exhale as we round and push on back into a child's pose. From here, let's drop the elbows onto the floor so your forearms are connected, nose is close to the floor. We'll inhale, slowly slide your nose forward in between your hands like you're pushing a marble, and it will land right in front of your thumbs. From here, pushing into your hands, lifting head and tail, inhaling. Exhaling into cat as we round it on back. Again, dropping elbows, sliding forward, feeling the shoulder blades sliding down the back, lifting head and tail. Exhale, rounding. So we'll keep it going like this. This is just a great way to also warm up our connection to our spine, but it also begins to activate a little bit more of the lats, especially as we pull ourselves on forward. And the strength in our triceps as we push ourselves on up. Also warming up the hip flexors as we sit on back and then reach on up. So lots of different things in this movement. Beautiful. All right, and then we'll come back to neutral and coming up to sit on the knees. All right, great work. So those were a couple variations of cat-cow on all fours. Feel free to utilize them in any of your classes that whether you take or do yourself or teach. Bye-bye.